panel guests are two of the brightest young stars currently walking the cobbles of Coronation Street. One plays handsome womanizer Tommy Duckworth, and the other unlucky in love Rover's Return barmaid Tina McIntyre, whose string of failed relationships would rival that of our own Janet Street Porters. Together, Tommy and Tina have kept viewers gripped with their will-they-won't-they romance.
Well, you know, it's got potential.
Yeah, right.
Hey, look, it's close to our local amenities.
Isn't it what's on the inside that counts? No, you know, it'll look more homely once I've unpacked and stuff.
What's homely about a million tops?
Oh, God, tell me, what have I gone and done?
Hey.
Please welcome the actors who play them. It's Chris Fountain and Michelle Keegan. Hello, hello, hello. So is that the start of something lovely?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's been the start of something since I got there. It's kind of just been literally like a big chase for Tommy, and he's just not letting up at all.
But
I think
Tina's starting to feel it now as well.
Yeah, starting to soften up a bit now. His persistence has worked, so guys watching, it works.
Just
keep
going.
Just keep asking.
How long have you been there?
It's a year. It'll be a year on Valentine's Day.
Right. Because I was there in 93, I started, when little Tommy was born.
Yeah. I mean, I think there's been two lads who've played Tommy so far.
That's right, yeah.
One of them was actually Sam Aston's brother, who plays Chesney.
Was
his brother, Joe, played Tommy first, yeah.
There's a whole other legacy. I mean, that's the amazing thing about Coronation Street and EastEnders. Oh, it's a choke to say that, but it's true. The fact is, you can bring characters like you right from the past, and you can't do that in any other drama at all, can you?
It's
so what's it like being a Duckworth?
Well, I'd say it's difficult. I wouldn't say it's difficult because it's just a bit of a torch to carry for me. I mean, to turn up and be a Duckworth when there's no other Duckworths there, Jack and Vera have gone, and to kind of hold that name is kind
of—they'll never go.
I know, yeah. They'll always live on it there, but
Michelle,
to kind of hold that name.
Michelle, you don't stand a chance, really, because you know who his father is.
Oh, I know, yeah.
Terry Duckworth. Uh-oh.
Do you think he's going to be a chip off the old block?
No, I think Tina will grind down anyway.
We've actually
got a bit of an exclusive announcement.
Yes, you found out.
We found out a couple of days ago that Terry's actually coming back.
He's going to cause trouble for Tommy and the rest of the residents on the street.
So does this mean that your new relationship that you're inching towards is doomed before it's even started?
We don't know. Like, literally, we've only just found out about it, but we know that he's coming back. He's going to cause trouble. But I think for me, I'm looking forward to it because it opens up a whole different side of Tommy that I can work with that no one's ever seen before, and I think he'll start to realise just kind of what type of dad he's got.
He won't have anywhere to live, so he'll have to live with you, won't he?
I hope not. he's already sold him off for a few grand a few years ago.
So, yeah. And do you think for you as well, you'll finally be lucky in love? Because, you know, you've been through the street.
Yeah.
And I say that.
Wow.
Is this true?
Yeah, she has been so. I think after Graham as well, and what he did to her with her friend, I think she needs a bit of luck, and hopefully Tommy will make her happy.
You have kissed every boy on that.
I really have.
I know. What is going on?
What's it like? I'm not complaining.
It's weird, isn't it, on screen?
Yeah, because it's weird, because it's like the only job you can get away with it. Do you know what I mean?
It's literally like the least attractive thing ever.
It really
like you're doing a kiss and everyone's like, it must be really like attractive and stuff, but you've literally got about 50 people, 5 cameras all pointing at you, and you're like, right, kiss. And you're like,
you do it again.
And no noise and no slobbering.
Yeah.
Exactly. I remember Chris Gascoigne used to go and have a coffee in a fag before, which was nice of him, Chris.
Nice.
But still, they don't know that's a Jane Danson.
Fred Elliott used to go and eat an egg sandwich before he kissed me.
Well, it's all coming out now.
Well, I'm going to have chewing gum and a bottle of water.
Always
so
a winner.
Are you both happy? You've got your own sort of relationships going on, and
I'm happy with my girlfriend.
In real life,
Michelle's obviously with Max.
He was in here a few months ago.
My partner's is a drummer in a rock band, and he's on tour a lot as well. I used to quite like it when he's away. How do you cope with it?
It's fine, because obviously I knew what his job entailed when I got with him. And like you said, it is actually nice when they go away and you miss them.
Yeah.
You look forward to seeing them again.
I'm kind of the same.
I used to love going to see him on tour as well.
I'm the same, really, because my girlfriend lives in London, so I'm obviously working up Manchester all the time, and then I kind of come down to see, like, I'm staying down till the weekend now to see her.
fizzling.
Yeah, it keeps it going. What is it absence makes the heart grow fonder?
Do you snoop then? Do you snoop into trouser pockets?
I'm not going to lie, I have done in the past. Not with Max, but I have done in the past.
What about Max, though?
I haven't done it with Max. I think once you get into that sort of thing by going on his phone or going on the laptop, that's it then. You're going to keep doing it and doing it and doing it.
But when they're away on tour, I went out with a rock musician once. Mm. When they're away on tour, don't you just think, it's so-and-so time there?
No, I think it's different.
You're putting doubts in her mind.
What are you trying to say, Janet? I think because I trust Max and we're constantly in contact with each other, and that's, I think when you're stable, you know.
I think Skype helps a lot.
Of course it does.
Like, it's so good.
Oh, you're funny, jerky pictures.
Yeah. But it's nice, though. I mean, I've like, sat on Skype.
Yeah,
watching
a dancer.
Yeah, yeah, she's training at the moment. And, it's great. I travel up and down, and she comes up to Leeds quite a lot to see me. So, no, it's good. It keeps it fresh, and it's really nice.
And how about the whole Dancing on Ice thing? Are you going to be involved in the tour when it comes out again?
I don't know. I'm not sure yet. I'm not sure if they've asked me yet. But, but no, I mean, I love watching the show. It's a passion of mine. Now, I mean, I never thought that after doing Dancing Ice, I'd be sat with my three or four of my friends, sat watching TV and going, "Oh, that was a really good Axel. That was brilliant." Sorry, the Olympics,
look
like
at
three 25-year-old guy. That's a brilliant edge. Look at that. These costumes, great. And then we kind of looked at each other and went, "Is this really happening?" But no,
have you kept any of that up since doing it?
Not really. I mean, I don't really get a chance to kind of go and for a start, I don't have a partner, so I get to the ice rink, do a couple of spins and a jump, and I'm kind of run out of things to do. So.
And would you ever fancy doing it?
Oh God, no! I couldn't put myself through it. I can't dance and I can't skate, so then together.
Painful,
just,
isn't it? I don't know how they do it because you can break things. Yeah, exactly.
It is dangerous. Like for
the
me, like
headbanger and stuff.
Yeah, I've done the headbanger now.
I did it
on the tour with my partner Brianne. No. When I skated with Brianne on the tour.
Yeah. I was one of the guest judges on the tour.
Yeah. And I fell over and she still voted for me.
Oh, you'll be there. You'll be together forever.
And what about eating together? I mean, do you find that, you know, when you're with girlfriends or what have you, that you maybe eat differently to say if you're out with a big lad like Chris?
Oh, no, I don't care.
I don't know how Michelle does it, because literally she eats like a horse. Like, literally everything. Like, you think she'd be there with, like, a little bit of broccoli, a little bit of chicken, and literally she just get McDonald's, everything, straight down.
I love
that metabolism that we want to put in a bottle in all drink. That's what you've
it's
got,
it's a nightmare, though, because I've been trying to watch what I eat in
a
minute, because I'm training with my friend Brendan, just trying to get in shape and stuff, and literally...
She's at
work with crumpets, with Marmite, cream cheese, and I'm there with a bowl of porridge, like, what's gone wrong here?
I could never go on a date and just go, oh, no, I'll have a salad, please. No, give me the steak and chips, please.
Good.
I'm not messing about.
Good for you. So what else have you guys got coming up? And obviously, are you going to be concentrating purely on Coronation Street for the next few months as your storyline builds?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm
really looking forward to it, because, I mean, Tommy's kind of been put as this womaniser, and he'd be doing this, but to actually get a storyline that opens it up to a whole different side of his character, I mean, it's gonna test, I mean, Tommy and Tina's relationship, so to have Terry come back, it's really exciting for me.
And what do you think about people saying you're the new Jack and Vera?
That's a big statement.
That's fantastic.
Not quite yet. It might be nice to go into them shoes, but
you want
a bit of comedy,
but I think, as it is now, I think Tina does wear the shoes, and I think Vera always wore the shoes.
Oh, absolutely.
And the trousers.
Yeah, but you wait till Terry's there.
I know. Yeah, but I think Tina will give him a run for his money as well.
I think she might.
Don't know. He's a bit of a character. He's a bit of a mean one.
He might fancy you.
I was going to say that.
Relationship with Terry.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you're writing the script.
Well, guys, it is lovely to have you on the show at last together. It's Chris and Michelle, everyone.